Hey, what's up everyone, Water Coaster here, and today we're going to be doing an updated video of Josh Allen's throwing mechanics. We're going to start the video right now. Alright, so we haven't done a Josh Allen video for a while here, and I've got a couple recommendations to be able to actually get a new updated video of him, so we'll go ahead and do just that. This is going to be some actual game footage. Before it was, well, I do have game footage, but when he was in college, and then I have his pro day, so now we'll get some actual NFL footage here. And we're going to start off, this was actually, I think, a couple of years ago, but we're going to start off with one of his better throws, I think, you know, in his whole career, which is just the side pocket throw. We'll just go through the actual play here real quick, where he just puts that ball right on the money right there, which is just like an absolutely crazy throw, probably about 35 yards downfield, and, you know, what was basically had the same trajectory the entire throw. So real quick, let's go into some of the basics that really stand out. And you know, he's a unique guy in being able to have the height that he does, and because he has the height that he does, he could stay a little bit more in that bent knee position. But even so, what's important to notice is look at his balance, right? When looking at this actual form and where he is, what stands out to me is where he's just like totally balanced with the ground, right? And I think that that's a super important thing to really consider, is when you're trying to put a lot on the ball, whether it's velocity or throwing power, you got to come from a position of balance in order to really utilize your entire back leg in order to make this throw with any type of velocity, right? So he's really balanced there. Another thing that stands out is look at how quick he gets that front foot down, right? And this allows him to have plenty of time to be able to shift all of his weight from that back leg onto the front leg. So I see a lot of guys that will go and they'll have that front foot off the ground for a good amount of time. And when that happens, what happens is when that front foot touches the ground, there's already so much weight shifted onto, you know, that front leg. And obviously he has a little bit wider base, has more bent knees, and could still be pretty tall because he's, you know, naturally such a tall guy. So not everybody's going to be able to do that, but you can still have success in being able to come from a balanced position and being able to get your front foot down quickly and keeping your weight back, right? He has longer legs, so even though he starts shifting his weight forward pretty early, he still has about 50-50 here when the foot touches, that front foot touches the ground, right? So we can really work on, if you're maybe 6'1" or you know, shorter, you do not want to have as wide of a base and just make it so you can get that front foot down and keep more weight onto the back leg, and you could still shift all of your weight forward after you do that. So we can see that he is shifting his weight forward from there, and also notice where he's coming from that ball carriage, right? We get a lot of people that talk about how, you know, oh yeah, the ball needs to be up by the chest and blah, 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 blah. It doesn't seem to be a 100% necessity. He is pretty low with the ball here. I'm just saying that, I think probably because I'm a little bit biased, because I do the same thing with my, you know, ball carriage. But point being is, you know, not everybody's going to come from the chest. He's a little bit lower here from when he starts, and that just helps him in syncing up his ability to drive that elbow through and get all of his weight onto that front leg. So notice he's just pushing a ton off that back leg. He has great range of motion through the lower back, through the hip flexors, right? That the front part of the hip here, and that allows him to create a lot of extension in the lower back, as well as get a lot of ability to open up within that hip. And that allows him to create a lot of rotation as he's coming through the throw, and also creates a lot of disassociation. So he gets a lot of hip rotation right here, where that hip is totally turned around and he still has that shoulder pretty far back behind, and more importantly, the ball really far back behind, not the head, but back behind the elbow, right? Notice the difference there. And then he drives that ball through from that position, very stable on that front leg. We'll get the behind angle as well. And the more that I'm doing this, guys, it's like, I feel like we could do like an easy hour, 2 hour tutorial on all different parts of going into the throw. So I'll try to limit it down so it doesn't get you, you know, you don't end up being too bored of the whole thing. But, you know, we do want to make it so you can get a good understanding of what you could do in order to really maximize your overall mechanics here. So again, notice here, pushing off that back leg, getting a ton of rotation off of that, the hip, having a ton of ability to absorb through that front leg as he's pushing all that weight off that back hip, and then just has a great ability to maintain a upward position within the spine. And even though those hips are coming all the way through, still has that ball pretty far back behind him as he's releasing. And then he just really flicks that wrist. And notice he doesn't get that elbow up, right? I see a lot of guys that after they release the ball here, their elbow gets high. And, you know, so as they're coming through, they almost end up in more of like this position, right? Notice how when he goes through, bow, he swings that arm all the way through and continues through the throw, right? That front arm is in a good position and he's able to really control his body and his arm as he's continuing his motion. All right, so this is gonna be a great example of just making a play, right? So the last video is more if you have a perfect pocket, a perfect situation, you gotta be able to drive in a ball and how you could do that in a game situation, right? There's not a lot, very many times that that opportunity is going to present itself. It's gonna be much more these types of situations where, you know, he's gotta be able to kind of escape out to the side, gets those hips turned around, right? And, you know, just puts the ball out there. Now, you know, notice that he's here, flips those hips quickly, and then gets a little bit more of like a front arm extension and pulls back harder with that front arm. So now he's in a position where he's not able to generate as much off that back leg, right? Because of how his body was set up beforehand. So now instead of utilizing as much of his back leg, he still uses his back leg. You know, it's not like he doesn't utilize it at all, but as much back leg here, he really uses a little bit more of that front side mechanics to really drive through that and that arm to really drive through here. And we see this a lot with Herbert as well, where he gets that front arm way out in front and really drives that front arm back. And that's a great way to be able to generate force as well, right? You're not always gonna be able to throw the ball perfectly every single time with perfect mechanics. So you do wanna have, you know, the ability to flip the hips and make a throw. You do wanna be able to throw on the run. You do wanna be able to throw off of the different types of hitches. And that's why I have so many different types of videos that go into those different types of mechanics as well. Cause I see so many guys that just focus on, you know, a regular step and throw, or, you know, just throwing one-on-one to a, you know, receiver and, you know, just don't have clean footwork when doing that. So, you know, taking a bunch of hitch steps, throwing really close to the line of scrimmage, just doing things that are just not really realistic. The start of the play here, you know, was from the, what was it here is where they started to play, right? And so you can see that he's, you know, just from the beginning, we can't really see the whole thing here, but just from the beginning, he's already, 7 yards behind, and then he has to go and scramble. So now he's 8-9 yards behind the line of scrimmage, right? Again, I see guys all the time doing, you know, one-on-ones or, you know, even 7-on-7, and they're throwing from 1-2 yards behind the line of scrimmage, and it's just not a realistic look that you're giving yourself. You know, he's his back foot's 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage here as he begins to, you know, chuck this ball. So just giving you guys a better understanding of what it's gonna take to really continue to build up your game here. And all those small details matter, right? Because now you can actually get yourself more prepared for game situations. So he's, you know, made this throw, I'm sure plenty of times, had to go out, rolling out to the left, turn the hips and be able to throw, right? And so just being able to add to your repertoire. Now, you know, you do wanna be good at the 3-step drop, the 5-step drop, the 5-and-hitch, all those types of things too. And I would say you wanna make sure that you're good at those before you could do this type of stuff. But, you know, as you start to get better and can, you know, work on the 3-step drop and the 5-step drop and get that more consistent, now these types of throws end up being something you can work on in order to really work or ensure that you have a game that has all the necessary components in it to be able to be successful when you play your games. All right, this is a great throw. Obviously, not everybody could do this. Big thing that just stood out is that he just goes and gives the receiver an opportunity right before halftime here. Now, this is another great play and another great opportunity to be able to learn from, you know, one of the best to do it. Again, this is where the line of scrimmage is. It's 10 yards behind the line of scrimmage, 10, 11 yards behind the line of scrimmage. But anyway, point being is that he, you know, really takes a big drop back, gets plenty of space, and it's 1st and 15. They end up only blitzing, you know, 4 guys, and they have plenty of guys to be able to protect. They chip both ends, right? So he knows he has plenty of time back here, right? This is not something that we're going to get all the time, where we get just plenty of protection and we're able to sit back and make a throw. But when we do, we want to be able to take advantage of that opportunity, right? And I know that this has caught plenty of us off guard, right? All of a sudden, you think that there's going to be some type of blitz. There's a lot of people in the box. And then all of a sudden, there's basically no pressure at all, and you have to be able to still decipher what's going on. So this is basically a prevent look. This is cover four. Look, you can see, you know, these guys are both in the flats. Nobody even cares about those guys, right? They're everybody's back, and he's still going to attack this, right? So a lot of guys would go and look at this and be like, oh yeah, these guys are open. We should hit this, right? But he has the ability to see downfield and see that this guy falls over, right? Again, how many times have we seen on film, oh shoot, this guy was wide open. I wish I would have made that play. Oh shoot, this guy fell over, made this guy, you know, open. There's tons of opportunities that we miss because we're not looking downfield, not having the anticipation needed to be able to have success when it comes to, you know, playing in these big games. And this, you know, as much as Josh Allen has a strong arm and has a lot of capabilities from a athletic standpoint, this is why he's able to play on Sundays, because he understands how to read the defense and how to make the play, right? There's everybody can do this, but not everybody does do this. And the reason why is because they see, boom, this guy's open, throw the underneath throw, right? Get 5 yards, 7 yards, whatever. You're not going to be upset about that. First and 15 turns to second and eight, right? You're continuing to move the chains. You're continuing to be just like every other quarterback. Right? There's a reason why he was a first round draft pick and why he is, you know, really one of the top quarterbacks in the NFL and in the AFC, is because he can make these type of plays, right? This is something that not everybody can do, but you want to be able to see this and be like, okay, this is something I can learn from and be able to recognize that I can work on being able to find and expose defenses when I have the opportunity, right? Yes, he has good mechanics. He pushes off that back leg. He drives off of that back foot and is able to shift all of his weight forward and is able to throw a great accurate throw here, right? Look at how where that front arm position is, right? We want to be consistent. This is why having consistent mechanics is important, because when you have this opportunity where you can step into your throw and have the opportunity to have great mechanics here, we got to be able to put this ball right on the money when we have these opportunities, right? These got to be touchdowns. We can't, when we have a wide open guy, miss those throws, okay? All these small details, again, matter when it comes to taking your game from the next level. So whether you're a high school guy trying to be a college guy, or even a JV guy trying to be a high school starter, right? A varsity starter, a college guy looking to go to the NFL or going to a professional league, all these things end up making a big difference in making sure that you're able to make that jump from where you are now to where it is that you want to go. So I hope being able to look at this gives you guys a little bit more perspective and just helps you out in being a better overall quarterback. If you'd like to get some more help, check out the description down below. We have a ton of different options for you. We have a couple free options with our 7-day free trial, as well as our free quarterback ebook. And then we also have the best thing that we have is a throw breakdown, 4 weeks. You're going to get unlimited breakdowns for a month. You're going to see huge improvements within the throw. It's the thing that I recommend for everybody. Even right now, I do individual Zoom session with guys. You know, I'm just so committed to helping you guys in improving as quarterbacks. And I appreciate everybody that ends up going and either joining the program or, you know, doing the throw breakdowns or doing the custom programming. You know, the big thing about me is I'm going to make sure that if you join one of these programs, you're going to get a ton out of it. I'm hugely committed to you guys when you go and show that support for what it is that I'm doing and making it so you have some type of commitment, even to yourself. You know, I want you to get a positive affirmation to, you know, joining something that and investing into yourself, because I think that's wildly important. So I really want to show up for you guys when you decide to do that. And I really, really appreciate everybody that decides that they want to give me the opportunity to help them in improving as a athlete. So I love what I get to do. I love being able to help out quarterbacks. I love being able to connect to you guys, talk to you guys, help you guys out. I answer any questions you might have. And so when you guys do this, it gives me a huge opportunity to be able to do that with you. And you know, the least amount of time that you get is gonna be the 4 weeks, right? It's still 4 weeks, it's only $97. Again, I think it's a great deal. But then we also have like a 3-month program. So 3 months of being able to communicate, go back and forth, you know, be able to really build up a great relationship. I love it. It's honestly a lot of fun. And, you know, we've gotten to be able to build more and more over the years here. And, you know, I'm going to continue to make these videos no matter what, so you guys can get this free information as well. And if you guys like this, you know, obviously click that thumbs up down below, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, leave any questions or recommendations or anything like that down below. And, you know, again, thanks for watching and talk to you soon.